Hey guys, it's Eddie the Magic Monk. In this lesson, we're going to talk about how to create tables and populate the tables with data inside phpMyAdmin. So I'm going to assume that you guys have already learned how to log on to phpMyAdmin and that you've already created a MySQL database. So if you don't know how to log into this page and you don't see a database that's already on the left, then you need to probably see your teacher to try and get it set up for you, or look up a tutorial on how to set that up. But once you've got it set up, okay, you're going to select the database that you want to create the table for, and you're going to type in the name of the table you want to create. So let's say I want to create a table for a student's database, right? Students in a school. So let's put in students. Now, how many columns do we want? So let's say we want 5 columns. So click go. And now inside the students table, we can decide what each of our columns are going to be. So here is where we type in the name of each column. So let's start off with the student ID. Student ID. And the ID is going to be an integer because it's just going to count up in whole numbers 1, 2, 3, and so on. And the ID is going to be our primary key. Primary key means that it's going to uniquely identify every single row in this table. So every single row or record is going to have a different ID. And you're going to click on auto increment because we don't want to manually set the ID every time. We want it to just automatically set it for us. Okay, then we have a student, let's say we want the students to have names. So first name, all right, the first name of the student, how many characters do you think it's going to have? So let's put in here 30 characters. Now, variable character, as opposed to integer, can store strings of text. So you can have A, B, C, D, and so on. So that's why we can't use integer, because integer can only store whole numbers. So first name is a variable character of 30 characters. Probably going to have a last name, another variable character, 30 characters. And let's put in here grade. Digits, right? Because you probably, well, the grades can only be from 1 to 12, so that's up to 2 digits. And then let's put in address, and that's going to have a lot more information. So let's put in text, because we don't know how many characters it's going to take up. Lastly, we want to choose a storage engine, and let's choose InnoDB, because if you hover your mouse over it, the tooltip that comes up says that it allows foreign keys, which is very important. So I'm going to create another table in a second with a foreign key that refers to the key in this table. So foreign key is basically a column that refers to the primary key in another table. So InnoDB, so click save, and now it's created the students table. So in the table students, let's insert some fake data. So let's put in here first person Edward Smith, grade 11, address 21 Jump Street. 21 Jump Street. Let's put in here just any suburb. Taipei, Taiwan. And let's put in here someone else. Emma Smith. Emma Jones. Grade 9. Address 5 Mars Street, Wellington. It's all made up. So just click go, and you can see that it's inserted 2 records. And this is the SQL that is used if you are interested. So if you click browse, and now you can see the 2 people. And then what we want to do now is I'm going to create another table. So let's go back to the database and let's click new to create another table. And this time I'm going to create a table called studies. So the table studies is going to have the student ID from the students table, and it's going to have subject name as variable character, let's say 20 characters, because the name of a subject is just put in 30 characters in case. And then if you save that, storage engine InnoDB, if you save that, now it has the studies table. So if you click studies, go to structure again, what you're going to do is basically checkbox both fields and click primary. Why? Because both fields combined makes up the primary key, right? Because the student ID is not going to be unique in this table, which you're going to see in a second. The subject name is not going to be unique, but the both of them combined will be unique for every single row. So let's insert some data, but just before we do that, let's click relation view, and we're going to make the student ID refer to the ID column in the students table. And if you click save, what's going to happen is when you insert some data, okay, for student ID, it is limited to what you've inserted in the other table. So the value is going to be 1 or 2. You can't have a value outside of that. So first student is going to study the subject English, and the first student is going to study subject maths. And let's insert a few new rows. Second student is going to study maths. Second student is going to study sport, and so on. So click go, and you will see that it's populated this table with some data. Student ID 1 is studying English. So what is 1? So you can click on that, and it shows you student ID 1 is Edward. Okay, so yeah, that's what's good about the foreign key. So you can click on this to find out who the student is. Who's student number 2 that studies sport? Click that. And it shows you that it's Emma Jones. Okay, thanks for watching this tutorial, guys. See you next time.